With you in 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 1 says, let so a man consider us as ministers of God, servants of God, and stewards of the mysteries of God. Let's read it again. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 1. Just as an encouragement, let a man so account of us. Let a man consider us as servants of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Paul was speaking this, that people should not take him in the high esteem. Though he had written almost 2/3 of the New Testament, he had greater revelations, he had planted churches in Asia and Europe, he had done mighty works that are undeniable, as he says, let so a man consider us as just servants. In the Greek context of his day, the word servant is interpreted as huperetas, literally meaning under rowers. These were prisoners that were in prison for life. Their assignment was to be hidden under the deck of the ship, and they acted as engines, rowing and rowing. Those were the servants of those days, as he was writing this context. And their work was to row until the boat goes to its sea destination. This message goes to each one of us here. I just want to thank God, the ministry team here, the pastoral team, the leadership team, and each and everyone that is making Kingsborough what it should be. The Lord says you are just an under rower. You don't do what you do to be seen by people, but your passion is let this vision go where it's supposed to go. That's why you give. That's why you seed. That's why you are available to do all the works of ministry without complaining. You are an under rower. You are rowing. There are people in church that just love to see things, but they don't know how things go. But there are people that are hidden and behind the scene, they are working. You may not see them on surface, but they are under rowers. I just want to thank God for every under rower in this room. You are not doing what you do because you want to be recognized, but your passion is let this boat go to its destination. As a man of God, I encourage you to be united in the work of the ministry. Amen. Let us be one mind. One man with one mind and lining up behind the vision of the pastor. What the Lord has called him to do. And we will see this ministry advancing and taking over the land. Glory to God. The next 30 minutes now. I've just come to declare what the Lord has laid on my heart. Somebody open Isaiah 61. Let me first clarify this issue seriously before I communicate a brief message to you. Isaiah 61, from verse 1 up verse 4. I was praying to God what this year holds. Most people, when you're sick and they prescribe a drug, you take it with all your heart that it is going to fix something. For example, if you have a stomach problem, what prescription do you take? Stomach problem. Let me go back to Africa. If I have malaria... If you're having a headache, what prescription do you take? You know that very well, that when you take it, it may not work immediately, but you are very sure it will fix the situation. Now, this is God's word to you concerning 2016. Amen. This is what the Lord gave me concerning 2016. And he says, I'll concentrate much more on verse 2 because of time. From above, he speaks about the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. The Lord has sent me to bind the brokenhearted. He has sent me to declare liberty to the captives, the opening of prison doors. But verse 2 is very important. I know you have read it many times, but I just want you to receive it as you're receiving paracetamol to settle the headache. Everybody, can we read together? Verse 2, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. I was instructed to come and talk to you that this is your acceptable year. If there has ever been a year to be highly favored, this is the year to be highly favored. In your family, in your ministry, in your workplace, everywhere. This is your year to be highly favored. I have come thousands of miles to come and speak to you to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. This is your year. You will be accepted wherever you go. Amen. The favor of the Lord is upon your life. Amen. In Psalms 44 verse 3, they never conquered the land because they were very strong. But the Bible says the Lord favored them. You may not understand what that means, church, to be favored in this community. You will understand it when things begin to unfold. Kingsborough, Family Church, you are highly favored. Amen. This is your year of favor in the ministry. Amen. I feel that from within. I've come to declare that. To proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. Look at Psalms 44 verse 3. For they not gain possession of the land by their own sword, nor did their own arm save them, but it was your right hand, your arm and the light of your countenance, because can we believe that the Lord has favored us as a church? Oh, receive the word. Father, we thank you that this year 2016 is the year to be highly favored, personally, individually, and collectively as a church, and we release the favor of God upon every man and every woman. Even our little children, Lord, whatsoever we do shall be favored because we are highly favored. We receive that in the name of Jesus. Amen. Isaiah 61 verse 2, the second point says, to proclaim the day of vengeance of our God. Everybody say, the day of vengeance. Now you can understand it in your own way, but this is my faith. This year, the Lord is taking over the battle. Amen. I said, this year, God is fighting for you. Amen. Tell somebody that God is fighting for you. He's taking over the battle. I wish you understood what I mean. There's no need to worry. Hallelujah. Even if they say they diagonize the sickness in your life, don't be afraid. Amen. I don't care what is happening right now, but what I know, God has taken over the battle. Amen. I'm serious what I'm talking about. Amen. In the book of Exodus chapter 14, Exodus 14 from verse 1 up to verse 30, all those verses, I just want to pick just verse 10. Exodus 14, everybody remember that Israel had been in bondage for how many years? 400 and... They didn't know that one day, everyone say one day, that things would change. They didn't know that. Joseph prophesied in Genesis 50, and he said, I know the Lord will visit you. You will get out of this land. Things will get okay. Generations passed, three kings passed until Moses was raised. And when Moses went, he spoke to them, the Lord your God has visited you. They could not believe him because of the anguish of their spirit. How does the Lord visit? He sends a messenger to tell you. Yes. You may not see the wings of the angels. He sends the word. Amen. And when Moses spoke to them, to cut the story short, a time came and the Lord said, enough. That's chapter 12 of Exodus. Enough is enough. This month shall be the first month of all of the, it was not January. But he said because he was planned to do something. Like some of you here, this year, great testimonies are coming your way. Amen. I say you must testify. Amen. with your own lips, with your own lips and your own eyes, you are going to see what the Lord is going to do in your life. Exodus 14. The children of Israel left Egypt with rejoicing. But unfortunately, Pharaoh followed them, running after them. They say, how could we let them go? We need them. No, they cannot go. And as they were on their journey, looking back, that was Pharaoh's 600 chariots, dust moving up. In front of them was the Red Sea. Over the sides were mountains. They had no wisdom. They said, want their graves in Egypt, pastor. Why did you bring us here? We would have stayed back. And Moses, as a man of God, says, stand still and see the salvation of the... Just help me, sir, and open Exodus 14, verse number 13 and number 14. Please help me. Just help me. Verse 13. And Moses said to the people, all of us, do not be afraid. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. For Egyptian you see today, you shall see no more forever. 14. 14. All of us. The Lord will fight for you, and you shall hold your peace. That's the message this year. The Lord will fight for you. Let us allow the Lord to take over. Don't be worried of anything. Let the Lord take over. And you know how he did it? Look at verse 19. The Lord began to engage in the battle now. Verse 19, sir, it says, and the angel of God went before, who went before them? Moved and went behind them. The angel shifted direction. The pillar of fire, another or whatever cloud, shifted direction and came at the rear side. And between the Egypt, the enemy, and there was darkness this side. They could not catch them. As God was at work. You may have, your immigration status may not have been settled yet. But the Lord is putting a wall. They cannot catch you. They cannot catch you. I had a testimony in Bristol way back. The police arrested one of my friends. He had been here 8 years. The visa was over, you know. And so they wanted his fingerprints. On putting on the fingerprint, the machine freezed. And they said, what can we do now? You can go. Such narrow escapes. Don't be worried, even if they have turned you down many times. There's a wall of protection behind you. And during that night, the Lord made the way by his own authority. Wind blew the waters. There may be waters in your life. Allow the wind of God to blow. He's going to blow. Are you hearing me? And then they were able to cross. Even in that process, the Lord from the cloud looked unto the enemy with a terrible look. With a terrible look. As if he was saying, what are you after this man? Why are you troubling my children? The Lord gazed with a terrible look. Said, terrible look. May the Lord look at your enemy in a terrifying way. Let the Lord look at them in a terrifying way. As if that was not enough. The Lord came down and removed the wheels. Removed the wheels. And they drove them with difficulty. There is a verse which I love. It says, they said, let us leave Israel. Their God fights. Where is that verse, sir? Give me the verse. Give me the verse. Megema, sorry. Oh, dear. Oh, help me. Oh, just get me my. I want to kill myself. Praise the Lord. Where's that verse? 25. And he took off their chariot wheels, so that they drove them with the difficulty. And the Egyptians said, let us free from the what? Tell me, church, let us free from the face of Esau, for the Lord fights for this year. The Lord is fighting for you. People are going to say, this person, you can't manage her. You cannot, if you're, there are people that are raising up against you. They don't know whom they are raising up against. A time has come, your God will be seen. Amen. Give a hand of praise to God, all of us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the last verse, verse 30. When they had crossed over and the enemy had been drowned into the waters, the Bible says, and Israel saw the great work of Jehovah. How the Egyptians are being killed, and they believed God, and they trusted God and his servant Moses. Listen, this is very serious. This year, you are going to see the mighty works of God. Amen. And the end result, you are going to rejoice. Amen. The way God fights is quite different from the way we understand things. I was just, let me just speak about this in 2 Chronicles 20. Just only like that. Israel was terrified. Judah. Jehoshaphat was told that the Anam has invaded you. You know the story very well, isn't it? But as they gathered before God in verse 13, they said, we don't know even what to do. There are things that come into your life, you don't know what to do. But we are looking unto. And the Spirit of God came upon Jahaziel. He prophesied and said, stand still. You will not need to fight. The Lord is going to fight for you. Amen. To cut the story short, when you read the whole story, as they began to sing and praise, it's amazing. The worshippers were the one ahead, praising the name of the Lord, of his goodness. And then the enemy ran into confusion. The children of Ammon and the other came and attacked one another. They began to kill themselves. And after their thing, said, kill me, please. He killed him. I know I killed him. They killed him. And the battle was won. Do you know that God can cause your enemies to fight themselves? Amen. So let me say like this. 2016, this is what the Lord told me to tell you. To proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. Number two, the year of the Lord's vengeance. You are going to see how God fights. Number three, Isaiah 61. To comfort all who mourn. Everybody said to comfort all who mourn. Take this as you take paracetamol. It is fixing something. Isaiah 61 verse 2 as we finish it. To comfort all who mourn. To console those who mourn in Zion. Come on. Let us read all of us now. To console those who mourn in Zion. To give them. That's what the Lord is purposing to do. Number three. The oil. Now, which of the two do you need? Do you need the mourning or the oil of joy? Now, pick up what the Lord is speaking to you. Read again now. To console. Now, look at me, all of you. We are seated here. We are not the same. There's somebody who is mourning. It's one thing to just strengthen yourself. You pick up your rags, but you know what you're going through. And you may not expose it to everyone. At church, you want to look happy, all of us. Especially ladies, some hair covering the eyes. You don't know what's happening. But you see the hair on the head, but you don't know. And the Lord is visiting this year, he says, to console all who? More. Number two, to do what? To give them? Number three? Do you know what's called the oil of joy? There is joy by faith. But there is a joy that comes to you with a testimony. You are not understanding it. I will let you know. When the Lord has done wonders, you rejoice. There is a church that is renting. The joy at King Zibara, having your facility where you can worship God, not pushing you like a 2 hours gawe, 1 hour gawe. You don't understand that. There's a difference. Somebody with a testimony and another one without a testimony, they are not the same. Yes. The one with a testimony is quite different. He says, I thank the Lord. The Lord has been so gracious. He has provided when the accounts are building up. Things are swelling. You know what I mean? Now, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of what? Do you know that somebody can be putting on the garment of mourning?
Lord, will you ever, Lord?
That's a garment. The Lord says, that one has to be taken away. And he's giving you the garment of what? And when the Lord has done this, that they may be called ox of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified. This is what the Lord is telling you, Kingsborough. When the Lord has done all this, he says, you shall be trees of righteousness.
Amen.
The planting, not to be uprooted anymore. The planting of
yes,
the Lord.
Yes, yes.
That he may be
glorified.
Whatsoever the Lord is doing in your life this year, the end result, that he may be
glorified.
Say, Lord Jesus, be glorified in my life. Whatsoever you want to do, whatsoever you are purpose to do in my life, may you be glorified in Jesus'
name.
3 points only. The year of the Lord is favor. The year when the Lord is taking over the battle and the Lord is going to comfort Ohumon. Now, that's a prophecy. As I draw to the closure, my message now is, get set. My message to you, having heard of the prophecy, get
set.
Have you ever seen people running a marathon? They say, on your marks, get set, go. It's a preparation from within. God is everywhere, tell somebody. Tell her again, but he visits. Are you aware that he visits? And wherever God visited, there was an urgency. There was a fervency. There was a demand that God, this is my year. I believe whatsoever he takes. Lord, you are going to do it. Wherever God visited, he visits those who have put a demand on the anointing. You know what I mean? He's everywhere, but he visits. And before he visits, people have to be prepared for the visitation. Now get set for what the Lord is going to do. If you're a minister, begin to be prepared. Prepare yourself in prayer. Position yourself where he can lay his hand on you because he's about to do something. Men that are doing business, strategize your business plan. Something is about to happen. Men that have visions and dreams, write them down. Write it down on paper. I want my own business here in the UK. I'll not be employed from time to time. I've to get my own agency and I employ other people. Write it down.
Amen.
You get what I mean? Because the Lord is about to do something.
Amen.
Let me just give you one scripture. In 2 Kings chapter 3. 2 Kings chapter 3 from verse 4. I'll just speak much of it. You can read for yourself because of time. Right? 2 Kings. Three kings gathered together to fight one king. Simple. They all brought their armies. The king of Moab, the king of Israel, king of Judah, and the king of Edom, they gathered together to fight Moab. They brought all their armies together, three kings with all their armies. You can now number them. And the Bible says, verse 9, they encircled round about. Let us read all of us. So the king of Israel went with the king of Judah and the king of Edom, and they marched on that roundabout route 7 days. And there was no water for the army, nor for the animal that followed them. Full stop. With horses, you know horses here so much. They tracked round about a radius of 7 days with horses. I think they can ride from here to where? Tell me, who can guess if a horse has set to run for 7 days? Where is it stopping? Maybe Wells. Now, all that journey round about 7 days, there was no water. And the water became an issue. They said, we need water. The animals began to faint. The army began to faint. And they didn't know. They were confused. And verse 10 says, please, all of us, let us read, all of us. Church. Yes. Verse 11. Yes. Isn't there. Listen. You may have been in the long queue. You are searching something and you are not finding it. Everything turns around by the prophetic message. That's what you need. He said, isn't there a man of God that we may inquire of him, of the word of the Lord concerning my situation? And they said, Elisha, who used to water the hands of Elijah, is very good to track with your pastor. I want to tell you, because what is on him flows straight on you. You get what I mean? It's very good. If you have got the opportunity to be close to the man of God, please don't lose that opportunity. Even if it means waiting for years and years, you just be there. And Joseph said, let us go. So they went to the man of God. Verse 15, please. Verse 15. Are you there? All of us. Now, they went to the man of God. There was a big story behind, okay? They went to the man of God. Mm-hmm. But now, bring me a musician. Then it happened. When the musician played, that the hand of the Lord came upon him. Uh-huh. And he said, thus saith the Lord, make this valley. That's very important. These guys had searched for water for how many days? Three kings with three legions of armies. Think about it. No water for 7 days. They looked into the hills, into the valleys, into the holes, no water. They come to the king. The prophet says, make this valley full of ditches. You just dig ditches. And he says, for you will not see wind, neither will you see rain, but the valley shall be filled with water. Makarabasekete. For thus says the Lord, you shall not see. Some people are looking for signs. What the Lord is going to do, even if there are no signs. Water is coming. These guys got the horse, the spades, the clubs. They began to make ditches as big as they could make. And one asked them, are you stupid? What are you doing? We are digging ditches for the water. Water is coming. We are preparing for revival. We are preparing for something which is about to come. I said, no, there's no water for the last 70 days. I said, don't worry. The prophet has said the word, let us make ditches. They made ditches as dust was rising. It may look as if it is stupid, but preparation is very important for what the Lord is about to do. Preparation is very what? And God is going to amaze you. And the Bible says in verse 20, they dug at the ditches. Let me tell you this here. Even if you don't dig ditches, water will come. But the only difference will be them that dug ditches, they will have some reservoir for themselves. But for you, you wake up in the morning when the land is wet, but you didn't dig any reservoir, so the water has gone away. Have you got the prophetic? It will come. I have all assurance that water is on the way. And verse number 20, all of us, things change. Now it happened. It always in the what? Weeping may endure for joy cometh in the. Are you believing God for joy to come? My goodness. Now it happened in the morning when the grain offering was being offered that suddenly, water came. Give a hand of praise to God. You may not understand the joy of this army drinking, others bathing, others swimming. Oh my God! Because the water had come. Kingsborough, I've not come here just to stir you up, but the waters are coming. Amen. You've got to be like Elijah who said, I hear the sound. Something is about to do what? Something is about to do what? One testimony as I finish. My sister, I have a sister church called Miriam. Miriam came to our church when she was 29 years. Now, I think at home, that's when a girl is not married at 29. We have believed God for a husband. You know, these women things are not easy things, marriage things. We believed God to bring someone. We did some connections as we could. When a brother would say, I need, I say, there. You pass the other side. We did all the connections. And even the connection didn't work. And I said, Lord, this girl is not cursed. She has been faithful to me for 10 years. Tithing fully. She's at my heart. I love her. But I was having pain. Where would the husband come? Last time before I left it, a month ago, another pastor came to me, man of God, needing a woman. I say, it did work. When I was searching on him 3 weeks ago, I said, Miriam, did the other man come back? He said, Pastor, no. I said, God, this year. But she told him, Pastor, don't worry. You prophesy that this is the year to be highly favored. The Lord will fight for me. He's going to console me. I'm no longer praying for this issue. I did already. I'm thanking God because the answer is on the way. Yeah. I have good news. God is my witness. A man surfaced. They are now waiting for Bishop Samuel to come and do the rest of the work. Water came. Water from Miriam. Now she's 39. You may be a sister and you're wondering, Lord, what's happened to me? When I look in the church, nobody is saying something. Saying, no, don't worry. The waters are
coming.
Any financial difficulty you're going through, the waters are
coming.
Stand on your feet and thank God for the prophetic word. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you. You are fixing something this morning, Lord. I bless your holy name. This is the year to be highly favored. This is the year to be highly favored. The year, Father, when you are taking over the battle, you are fighting on our behalf, oh God. Let God arise and enemies be scattered. Arise, my God. Arise, my God. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Somebody is receiving the oil of joy.
Hallelujah.
True testimonies of the workings of Jehovah.
Hallelujah.
With our own eyes we will see what the Lord is yet to do. The waters are coming. The waters are coming. May you dig ditches. Dig ditches. Make ditches in the valley. Make ditches. Make ditches. Let the valley be filled. Rekosanda rarabazia. Ikara rarabasete kemama. Manda brosiande. Oh, shit. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let us agree together. Raise up your hands. Get set for what the Lord is going to do. If there's been any doubt, erase it out. What the Lord is going to do, you have no idea. He says, as you don't know a woman, bones develop in her that is pregnant. You don't know how God works. Don't ask Bishop Samuel, how will it happen? I also don't know. But what I know is going to happen. The waters are coming. Dig the ditches. The waters are
coming.
I decree and declare the true manifestation of God in your life.
Amen.
Let God arise and your enemies be scattered.
Amen.
I decree and declare the hand of God to be revealed in your life.
Amen.
We cross out every negative event that's been happening in your life.
Amen.
Let Jehovah arise over you with the singing.
Amen.
I declare a new song. A song of a testimony.
Amen.
With your own eyes you will see.
Amen.
Or what the Lord is doing in your life.
Amen.
I decree and declare.
Amen.
Family growth and enlargement.
Amen.
None of your family will lack.
Amen.
Because of the Lord's favor is upon you.
Amen.
And because of this favor, wherever you go, you'll be accepted.
Amen.
The Lord fights for you.
Amen.
The Lord comforts you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let your children and grandchildren grow in the fear of the Lord.
Amen.
There will be a mighty army.
Amen.
Men that will take leadership in this land.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May the God I serve go before you.
Amen.
Make your path straight.
Amen.
Cause you to dance.
Amen.
And rejoice in his goodness.
Amen.
This year,
amen,
I speak divine health.
Amen.
Healing to your body.
Amen.
From the top of your head,
amen,
to the sole of your foot.
Amen.
Be made whole.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Give a hand of praise to God.
So make sure you add us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. And visit the church website.